is loose. I want to see you guys fighting for it.
And
it's game on.
Check the teams on the big screen, ready for a showdown. Hearts pumping, something big is gonna go down. Break away, are you ready to play game on?
In the beginning, actually, we had a lot of youth, different age groups, and we were thinking how to gather them in a spiritual and a Christian fellowship. They loved sport, and unfortunately, our churches were not equipped to give them sports as a daily thing, so we thought of this organization to gather all the youth in a sport day, which is great. I think it's been growing day, year after year. In this event, we have a lot of churches because they are. We have many out of the diocese. We used to start in Florida only, which we have about 8 to 9 churches, different age group. But now we have this year, we have a team from North Carolina, we have a team from Detroit, we have a team from Texas, Dallas, Georgia, Nashville, and many other places. And we thank God for this. It's, I would say, at least 15 churches are participating in this tournament, this event. It's very important because it brings the youth together. They know each other. I know they know each other probably by all the new social media things that are very common these days, but it's very good when they get face-to-face, know each other face-to-face in a Christian fellowship, away from any kind of worldly temptations. It will be very well when it is in a Christian setting. So I think it's very healthy and very helpful to them to grow spiritually. I hope for this event to grow more, to gather more for 2 or 3 days. That's actually our main goal, is to have a convention, a sport convention, when we have 2 or 3 days, when we mix spiritual parts plus sport parts. So it will bring the depth of the meaning of being together in fellowship, Christian fellowship. I hope that one day we will have a whole week of sport week for all the churches to gather from around the nation. That's my hopes and my dreams. Ba-ba-bum.
This is great. This gets all ages, the whole youth, the priests, to get together and have good fun, good clear fun, and they get the energy out of their systems.
One of the reasons why I like this tournament, it's
reunion of all the friends that we've met from back then, and get to meet new people, have closer friends in the future, and if you ever need anything, they always have each other's back. You know, it's like a brotherhood. It feels good.
Court number one. Again, we have Houston versus North Carolina. Houston versus North Carolina.
A successful event like this takes a lot of pre-planning. First of all, you know, getting in contact with, you know, a representative from each church, which is probably our most difficult challenge, if you will. Because we need somebody who's reliable, somebody that communicates well with their church, with the players, with the priests. So that's usually our number one hurdle. Usually after that, it's almost smooth sailing from there, because it's just getting the kids signed up, pretty much getting them familiar with the rules and what exactly we're trying to do with the tournament. You know, it's not just a basketball tournament.
Honestly, he puts in so much work for this, and it really pays off for everyone. Everyone comes and has a great time, and they all get their playing time.
The tournament is fun because I know a lot of people from a lot of different churches. So we basically come out here, yeah, we have some rivals, but we just come out here basically for fun. Like, we just got murked by Tampa, but we're still friends and we're cool.
I've been playing the tournament for about 5 or 6 years, and it's fun because like all the churches come together as one, because we really don't see each other, because like we're all like distanced from each other, so we all like once a year come, and we all play a basketball against each other. Honestly, like, it's fun. Like, we don't get rowdy, or we just, like, at the end of the game, we're like, good game. We still talk to our friends, so like we kind of laugh when we're in games, because like it's our friends we're playing against.
I'm very happy to be with you today, attending this big event. Actually, this is my first time to come. Every year I hear good news about this tournament, but today I'm very happy to come and be with you. So being here together, it is time. It's not about who's going to win and who's going to lose, but it's about how to enjoy our time in fellowship and the spirit of love.
When the bishop came today to the tournament, it meant a lot to everyone. I know for a fact, just seeing everybody's reactions, everybody's emotions, everybody's cameras coming out and taking pictures, it meant a lot. He definitely blessed us, even though he didn't stay that long, but it was definitely a big, big blessing. I know it meant a lot to me personally, so seeing him was really nice.
When the bishop came, it was a wonderful time, actually. First time in his presence came. He's really busy. He only comes to see, like, his churches, touch everybody's heart, even including myself. It's a great blessing to see his grace today, and hopefully we'll see him every time.
Yeah. Well, we fly to all 15 of us from Pittsburgh to be part of the brotherhood and community down here, the Coptic community. It's competitive, and we're obviously all competitive in some way. So it just brings us all together. It's a good way to communicate, see each other every single year. You know.
So all those churches out there that haven't been to this tournament, we would love to see you. Every year we get new participants, and we, you know, add a lot of character and a lot of friends to the tournament, and we'd love you guys to be a part of that.